Microsoft and Windows have become almost interchangeable names, thanks to the incredible success of Microsoft's easy-to-use, affordable operating system that's now a global standard. Over the years, we've grown used to seeing a new version of Windows released every few years, but after Windows 11 launched, nearly 4 years passed without any news of a Windows 12. So why was Microsoft holding back? And what would the release of Windows 12 mean? First, building a new operating system isn't simple. It takes years of development, rigorous testing, and endless optimization. Even though Microsoft has a long history of creating successful operating systems, the process still demands massive amounts of time, labor, and money. And for such a heavy investment to make sense, the final product would have to be truly groundbreaking, which is incredibly difficult today. Technology moves so fast that by the time a new OS is ready, it's often already behind the curve. If Microsoft rushed into developing a new system right after launching one, it'd be stuck in a cycle of constantly releasing operating systems that already feel outdated. On top of that, their marketing teams would be stretched thin, negotiating with manufacturers like HP to preload Windows on new devices, creating promotional campaigns, and educating customers about every new release. All of this effort would heavily tie up Microsoft's resources, and honestly, it wouldn't even guarantee a major boost in profits. Sure, Windows still brings in billions every year, but does Microsoft need to launch a brand new operating system to stay on top? The short answer, no. And here's why. Since the early 2000s, the consumer PC industry has shifted heavily towards simplicity and ease of use. The days of buying a separate Windows license from Best Buy or transferring an old license to a new computer are mostly behind us. Unless you're part of the small group building your PC, you don't even think of the operating system as a separate purchase anymore. For most people and businesses, you just buy a laptop or desktop and it works right out of the box. Today, most of Microsoft's Windows revenue comes from deals with computer manufacturers, not individual sales. Plus, computers now last longer and operating systems are more stable than ever, so people aren't rushing to upgrade every time a new Windows version drops. They might be interested, but in most cases, they'll just wait until it's time for a new machine. Because of this, Microsoft realized it could save billions by halting development on new Windows versions. Instead of constantly pouring money into research and marketing for each release, they can focus on refining what already works. They've also cut costs dramatically in customer support. Before Windows 10, they had to keep patching old versions long after newer ones launched, which was inefficient. Now, Microsoft can put all its resources into updating and optimizing Windows 11. Users still get regular updates, but they're mostly improvements to performance and stability, not major overhauls. In a lot of ways, Windows has hit its final form, and most users are perfectly happy with that. At the same time, Microsoft had another major realization. While tech giants like Apple and Amazon had rebounded and skyrocketed after the dot-com crash, Microsoft's revenue and stock price stayed mostly flat for 15 years. Even though the tech industry kept booming, Microsoft remained stuck selling operating systems and Office software, the same products they had built in the 1980s and 90s. That approach made sense when the digital infrastructure was still being developed, but by the early 2000s, the groundwork was already laid. The real growth wasn't in building the roads anymore. It was in creating the businesses that ran on them. Just look at Amazon. By the early 2010s, Microsoft's market cap hovered around $200 billion, while Amazon was pulling in tens of billions in annual revenue. Meanwhile, Google, Facebook, Alibaba, Instagram, and others were rising fast. Hardware and operating systems were still a big business, worth hundreds of billions, but industries built on top of them were worth trillions. When Satya Nadella took over as CEO in 2014, he understood this shift perfectly. Microsoft had already lost critical battles in email, search, e-commerce, and even mobile markets that it should have led, but there was still one booming frontier where Microsoft could win. The cloud. After taking over, Satya Nadella quickly shut down Microsoft's mobile efforts and other late-to-market projects. He also set a plan in motion to slowly scale back major Windows development and shift the company's focus toward cloud services. By the time Windows 10 launched in 2015, Microsoft's cloud business was already gaining momentum, proving it needed even more attention. To accelerate this shift, Microsoft made Windows 10 a free upgrade for users of Windows 7 and 8, helping them retire the older systems faster and redirect resources to the cloud division. Support for Windows 8 officially ended just 6 months after Windows 10's release, but few complained since the upgrade and new security updates cost nothing. Even as Microsoft moved toward free operating systems, it doubled down on its Office products by pushing its subscription service, Office 365. Unlike Google's free tools, Office 365 charged $70 a year, offering regular updates for Word, PowerPoint, and other apps. However, there was a smart strategy behind it. Most users, like students and office workers, weren't paying for it themselves. Instead, universities and companies picked up the tab, creating a reliable revenue stream for Microsoft while leaving the mass consumer market open to Google. Today, Microsoft's big moves have paid off hugely. The company no longer relies on personal computing for most of its income. Personal computing is now the smallest part of their business. Even when you count Xbox and Surface sales, revenue directly from Windows itself is just a tiny slice. Instead, Microsoft has become the second largest cloud provider in the world, right behind Amazon. They've also grown their Office and LinkedIn divisions, which now account for about one-third of their total revenue. If you've been wondering why Microsoft isn't rushing to release Windows 12, here's the real reason. Microsoft is no longer a consumer-first company. Sure, every day people still use their products, but the bulk of Microsoft's money now comes from business-to-business deals. Whether it's licensing Windows to Dell, selling Office subscriptions to universities, or providing cloud services to giants like Verizon and MSI, their focus is clear. Flashy new versions of Windows or Office aren't their priority anymore. Instead, they aim to make their products simple, reliable, and attractive to long-term corporate clients. And judging by Microsoft's soaring stock price, this strategy is working. That's why Windows 12 is not happening, not because of pressure, but because AI represents a true generational leap that makes a refresh worthwhile. Otherwise, Microsoft would have had no reason to rush. Did you realize Microsoft had transformed so much? Drop your thoughts in the comments, smash that like button if you think a free Windows 12 upgrade is a smart move, and don't forget to subscribe for more videos. Take care, bye!